Freshwater reserves are decreasing, given the fact that the global population is going to rise to 10 billion people by 2050, and that the agriculture needed to feed people already consumes 85% of the world's water, water recycling is essential for the foreseeable future. One option is to reuse industrial and municipal wastewater, the focus of the European research project Ultimate.
Water reuse is an alternative water source that is available all over the year and can be controlled in terms of quality, in terms of fit for purpose.
Here in Italy, Francesco Fattone and his team are developing strategies and technologies to recycle municipal wastewater for irrigation and industrial use. The challenge?
We have a serious problem of saltwater intrusion, and this causes an elevation of chlorides in the water, which gives difficulties in industrial reuse.
To address this, the researchers installed a reverse osmosis desalination plant to reduce chloride levels in the effluent. They've also installed a salinity early warning system to respond quickly to seawater intrusion.
The pilot has addressed not only technical solutions in terms of physical solutions, but also digital solutions. We are able to operate the infrastructure, the tertiary treatment, to send the water to reverse osmosis and reuse when salinity is higher, and to send the water directly to the user with minimum reverse osmosis when the salinity in wastewater is lower.
In Nafplio, Greece, the Ultimate research team is working with a fruit juice producer. Their goal? To extract polyphenols from the wastewater.
Polyphenols collectively act as antioxidants, but individual polyphenols have very specific properties, ranging from anti-cancer properties to anti-inflammatory properties to antibacterial properties.
A polymer resin is used to absorb the polyphenols from the wastewater. The polyphenols are then extracted either with hot water under pressure or by raising the temperature and increasing the pressure of carbon dioxide, which acts as a solvent. The large-scale test with a pilot plant at the fruit juice producer showed promising results.
We have been able to reuse 90% of the water byproducts and remove approximately 70 to 80% of polyphenols present in this water byproduct.
The extracted polyphenols have applications in the food, pharmaceutical and cosmetic industries, creating a new revenue stream while the remaining water is treated and reused. Water scarcity may be a looming threat, but scientific approaches like these are helping us turn that threat into an opportunity to create a world where not a drop is wasted.